Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I hope everyone's having a wonderful day and everyone's having a wonderful Ramadan. And just before we begin, I wanted to introduce myself. My name is Hidayah and I've been painting for 6 years now. And I've been with Islamic Art Society for about the same amount of time. They are a wonderful organization and I've had so many opportunities through them. So go ahead and check out their page after the live session, inshallah. And so just welcoming the early birds, and I'm going to start putting my paint on a surface so that when we start our paint along, it will be ready, inshallah. So right now I'm just putting my primary colors on my palette. We're going to need a lot of each of them. Alright, so I'm just putting the blue, red, and yellow first. And make sure you're comfortable. Sit in a position that you feel like you can work with. And also before we begin, I'm going to go ahead and show you guys a couple of things we can do to mix some colors. Wa alaikum salam, Fatima Josh, how are you? I hope everyone's having a great Ramadan. Alright, now I'm just adding some black and white to my palette. You're going to need a lot of white. I'm just going to add a dot of white right in front of the yellow. And one right in front of the blue. If you have a brown, that would also be a color that we're going to use today. We're going to see how to mix brown But if you have a gram already, that would be awesome. And then orange as well. And green, but we'll see how to mix them too. Okay, so that's everything I have on my palette. First thing I want to show you guys, we're going to need a purple. So if you want to mix a blue and a red, that would make purple. Blue and yellow would make green. And brown is a little trickier. So what you're going to need to get brown is you're going to need to mix a red and yellow, which makes orange. And then you mix that orange. So make sure to do this part first. The red and the yellow, which makes the orange, and then add in the blue, and that makes the brown. So I'm going to show you how to do that real quick on my palette. And today I'm using mostly flat brushes, because they work very well with architecture and buildings. So here we go. I'm going to get some red and some yellow. And there you see that makes a beautiful orange. And you might need to add a little bit more yellow in there to get that orange. You can also mix your colors with a palette knife. A lot of people like to do that. I've just gotten so used to using my paintbrushes as a mixing tool, so it's really up to you. The next color that we're gonna see how to mix is a purple. So you're gonna wanna get a little bit of red and some blue. And I love using purple as a shadow color. So you see how rich that purple is? I love that purple. So we're gonna use a lot of purple in this painting as a shadow. And then we're gonna see how to get our brown. So we already mixed in orange right there. Now the next thing you want to do is get some blue and mix that in if you're making your brown. If you're not making your brown, you don't need to do this step. But if you are, there we go, we got that rich brown color right there. And you might want to add some white later on when we start making the building. But there you go, you see that nice brown color. And it all also depends on what blues, yellows, and reds you're using, on what shade of brown you get. But this one's pretty dark because I'm using a crimson. Alright, I think we can get started now. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to make our sky. So most of you guys should know we're making a mosque today. And real quick about the mosque that we're painting, it's actually a very important mosque to me, and it's my local mosque, Marine Masjid. And actually, I've been to the mosque about so many times I can't even count, but it's been my mosque since like 7 years ago, and I just love it so much. It's just one of those things, you know, it's like your home away from home, and I just wanted to share that with everybody today. So we're just going to go ahead and get some blue, and we're going to add some white. See that beautiful light blue color? Okay, and now we're going to want to dip our paintbrush inside of our cup and just wipe it a little bit on the side of that cup. Now what we're going to do right now is called a wash. I do this a lot when I paint because I like to paint in layers. So if you hear me saying that we're going to do a wash, that just means that we're going to dip our paintbrushes and inside of the water just a teensy bit and then wipe it on the side. So let's go ahead and start putting that paint on the canvas. And it's already making this beautiful, brilliant sky. Skies are so fun and freeing to paint. It's one of my favorite things to paint. And you can make a sky in so many different ways. Today we're going to make a sunset type of sky. Just do crisscrosses across the top of our canvas. Just do it like that. And it's still a little wet on there, so we can blend the next couple of colors. Okay, repeat doing that crisscross pattern and go straight across as well after you do that. Okay. And then we're gonna add a little bit of red, which is gonna make a nice purple color. We're also gonna do a wash, so don't pick up too much red just yet. But we're going to dip our paintbrushes inside of the water and you get this purple color. And you can just go ahead and blend it in there. So it makes it a dark blue too. So you can just go ahead and swipe your paintbrush across. I'm actually going to grab some white and add it to my red over here. Just gonna go in again like this, just straight across. We've already got some gradation in the sky, so I love that. Alright, and then we'll grab some of our orange. You can add some white to that as well. We're gonna go right in there. We're gonna swipe across, do some crisscrosses. If you have a favorite brush for skies too, everyone likes to use different types of brushes for their skies, so it's all up to you. And I actually want to go back in with my red, because I want to get that red to be a little bit more seamless. And see, that just makes that look a little bit more blended. And go back in all the way to the top too. So one thing I also like to do is use a sponge brush. So I'm going to show you guys what a sponge brush could do. So you're going to want to get some of your red. And we're just going to go in circle patterns. If you have a sponge, you can do this. You can also, if you have a mop brush, you can do the same thing. We're just going to go in circles. It's going to make the sky look like there's some clouds in there. And I'm going to add a little bit more red as well. Just over here at the top. Just going to go in there just nicely like that. And that's what I like about the sponge brush, is that you can do so much with it. So I'm just going to go a little bit into that blue area, and I'm just going to move across my canvas. It's gonna look kind of like a watercolor effect. Now I'm going to take, for me, I'm not liking the blue as much, so I'm just going to add a little bit of white. And I'm going to go ahead and blend it in some more. I actually like how that looks. It looks like there's a cloud up here. So you can strike it also across the board. If you're wanting to make this faint cloud appearance. Okay. Now I just put my sponge brush down, but here we go. Get that nice blue in there. Again, I'm gonna wipe my brush on a towel so that it's just a little. And see, even when you come back in there and put some water on there, you can take away some paint, and that sometimes helps create some highlight. So I like to do that sometimes, add in a cloud or two when it's still wet. All right. I think I'm done working on my sky for now. I can go back in later if I really, really want to. If I really, really want to, I can later come back in with the sky. But I'm going to go ahead and do a wash of red or orange paint, whichever one you like, on the rest of the board. And this is just going to help make your scene a little bit brighter. Okay. Alright, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my 1-inch flat brush, and we're going to start planning out the solid shape of the mosque. So for this part, you're going to want to get your brown color. So whether you mixed it or you have a brown, you're going to want to get that brown color. You're going to want to start from the middle, so you're going to make a square, just one square in the middle. Could be closer to the bottom if you'd like. That's usually how landscapes work best, is when you start from the bottom. And it doesn't have to be perfect, so don't worry about that. We're just going to have some fun with our solid colors. Right now, planning out how it's gonna look like. Okay, the next thing we're gonna want to do is we're gonna wanna make a long rectangle. It's gonna go past the first square. We're gonna want to make one on both sides. And then we're going to make another rectangle right over here. It's going to look like it's coming across from the inside square. So we're going to do that. our main section of the moss, we're going to go back in with our brown, and we're going to make two long strips of solid color, and it's just going to be a little thinner than the other solid parts that we made. Now we have one more part to work on for this part, for this solid part of the mosque, and that's going to be the dome. So I just switched my brush to a smaller, not quarter inch, but half inch flat brush, and I'm just going to take my brush and I'm going to move it on the canvas and to make a half circle on the top of that middle square. So you're just going up and then down, and the flat brush will do the work for you. So you don't need to try and make a perfect half circle. It'll do it for you because the ends are straight already. So there we go, we got the solid part of our dome. And then we're going to make like a little indication of a diamond on the top of those two long sections. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna wanna finish the rest of this bottom part. And we can do that by taking our red, and we're gonna do a wash. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're going to grab some red, and then we're gonna dip our paintbrushes inside of our water. And we're just going to start by making a line that goes from this side, and make sure to go around the structure. And it's okay if it bleeds a little, it's going to add to the texture later on. Okay, so if you made this line, we're at a good start, and then we're going to take our paintbrush and we're going to go from one corner all the way to the tip of that minaret, and then we're going to do the same from the other side. We're going to go from one corner to the other tip of the corner of the panel. So then we're just going to start blocking in this section, and I like to do the crisscross because it does give that nice texture. So I'm just grabbing in some more red, and one thing that if you need to, you can step back, look at your painting, make sure that you're liking everything. That's one thing that I learned from one of my professors, is that it's good sometimes to take a step back and just look at your painting. So now I'm just going back in, making sure I like how this is coming along. Alright, and I'm just going to do this for just a minute, make sure everyone's at the right pace, and I hopefully can just do a little bit more crisscrosses, just to make sure everybody's on board. Alright, and that's the beginning. Hope everyone's kind of seeing where this is going. I'm just going to go around and do this curve over here. And at our mosque, we have a beautiful area where we have water. So that's where, that's what these two sections are going to be. So we can start off by getting a little bit of blue. Now if you want, you can get a little bit of blue along with some purple, but I'm just gonna start off with a blue wash, and then I'll add in some color later on. This is just to get us started. Everybody with me? Alright, so now that we've got our solids all in, it's time to start with our detailing. So I love this part, and we're gonna go ahead and we're going to get some of our brown, and we're going to mix in a little bit of yellow. We're gonna do that again, just make sure that we're getting a nice color. And if you've been to Masjid Maryam, it's a beautiful, beautiful mosque, and the color of the mosque is actually a bit of a green color. So when you mix a brown and a yellow together, it makes this nice and almost green color. If you want, you can add a little bit of green, but I'm not going to start off that way. So I like to start from the center. So I'm just going down and just accentuating the figure of that minaret. And we're gonna go down. You can go up to down to up. That's going to be the motion of our paintbrush. Again, I'm just mixing in that color. And it's probably best if you mix it in just enough so that you can complete it all, but sometimes I run out and I'll have to mix that color again. And that's alright, because we still have some of that color in there. Alright, it's looking a lot more solid now. This color. And we're going to keep doing that. So now that we've got that minaret in the middle section of the mosque, we're going to go ahead and keep going. Alright. And now at the side of that part, we're going to go ahead and add a little bit of brown yellow and make a small rectangle. We're going to do the same thing over here, and it's going to extend a little bit further than the mosque itself, the front part of the mosque. Now I just dipped my paintbrush in my water, and I like to do that from time to time, so that I don't get too thick of paint. But if you like to work thick, that's fine as well. Alright, and then we're going to go into the sides, and we're going to add in that solid bit of color. It's already starting to look like Masjid Maryam. And then we're going to go back into the other side and do the same thing. Now that we've got that solid part in, we can start doing some lights and shadows. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to get some of that brown and that yellow again, and we're going to want to mix some more of it and add a little bit more yellow. And what we can do now is we're going to add in some white. And this is going to make our brown a lot lighter. Kind of looks like a cream color. Alright, so now that we got that in there, we're going to start marking the left side of our moss because that's where the sunset is coming in. I just made a line from the top, and then we're going to make a line in the middle. I'm dipping my brush again into the water, and I'm coming back in to get some more color. And then we're going to do a line right at the start of that third shape. And then we're going to do the same with this minaret, and the same with the other minaret. I'm just dipping my paintbrush again in there. And I'm going back in to get that color. Now, we're going to do a little wash, and it's not too much of this light color, but we want to get just enough so that it shows that this part of the mosque is lighter than the part where the shadow is hitting. So now we're going to want to start making shadows, and I love this part. So if you don't have a purple, I like mixing my purple. So I'm going to get some red and some blue, and I'm going to mix them together. And keep in mind, if you do have your brown, that's okay if it comes into this color, because our shadow color, you're going to want to have that brown in it. So I'm going to grab some brown, put it in there. That's a pretty dark shadow. So what we're going to do is we're going to want to go down on the right side of that minaret and down on the other side of that minaret. And then we're going to put our brush inside of that water again, wipe it on the side of the cup, and then make sure we don't have that much. But we're going to come over here, that side of the minaret. We're going to make a triangle-like shape. Yeah. It's a little lighter than that shade that's on the minaret. And we're going to do that same thing over here on the right side of our mosque. And we're going to just swipe it across. And line. And then we're going to do another one right here in the middle. Okay, now you're going to want to dip your paintbrush in the water and then just wipe it. I like to wipe it on my apron, but if you have like a towel or something, you can do that as well. And then we're just blending that with the wiped brush into that brown. All right. I'm just cleaning up some of the spots over here. And you can do that the same thing over here with the purple that's on the minarets. You can just get some of that and just blend it in there. And you can do that by going up and down, up and down, up and down with your flat brush. Just move it in there. Alright, so now we need a door, because we can't walk into the mosque without a door, right? So I'm going to get some of my brown again, and I'm going to add some of that yellow again, and then we're going to add some white, and we're going to make a super creamy color. So then we're just going to go up here, and we're going to make a big entranceway. And inside of that entranceway, we're going to have a half ovular shape. And we're going to do the same thing over here in this third shape. So we're going to make a half oval. And over here as well. Now this is where the architecture of the mosque is really going to show. It's going to show because we are starting to add the doors and the archways. And we're going to want to add 1, 2, 3 squares. You can do that by pulling down on your brush, making little windows. And then we're going to go on the other side and do the same thing. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, and then we have another couple of archways, and it's going to be right below those windows. So we're going to have one archway here, and you can go up and down to make those archways. Up and then down to make those archways. And we're going to do that same thing over here. Up and down. Up and down. And down. Okay. So now I'm going to actually get my round brush, because I like to use that one when I'm making some details. So this is what a round brush looks like. It's just a little more, has a little more of a point to it. So now what we're going to do is we're going to want to get our shadow color again. We're going to go to our shadow color. Let's add a little bit of orange to it. And I'm going to dip it inside of my water. And this is also going to be, you can wipe that excess water off as well. And then we're going to go ahead and go into those archways. And we're going to go to the ones on the right side, because those are the ones that are actually going to be dark. The ones on the left side, on the other hand, are going to be a little bit lighter. So we're going to want to go in there. If you want a really, really, really dark shadow color, and we might actually want to do that on this side, so we're going to get some black, and we're going to add it to our shadow color. So just mixing that color. And because it's that dark, I want to dip in my paintbrush into the water again and wipe it. And we'll go back in and start just going up with our paintbrush. Okay, and we can do that over here as well. I'm going to add a little bit of brown to this section too. A little bit more brown to the shadow color. So I'm going to get some of that brown and mix it in there. And you can still kind of see the colors from underneath, which is why I really like to work in layers. At this point, we don't have too much water on our brush. We're just going side to side with our paintbrush. And I'm going to dip my paintbrush inside of the water once again. I'm going to go ahead and add a little bit of that rich, dark color on the side of the minarets again. And what I want to do with my round brush is make it a little more so that you can see that shape. Okay. I'm gonna go over here and add some more brown. And as we go more towards the right, that color is going to get lighter. And I just put a little water on my brush, and I'm going to go up here at the top and fill in those spaces. So now what we can do is we can go to that middle section and we're going to add some of the shadows there as well. I'm getting a little bit of that dark color, a little bit of my brown color. And I'm dipping that brush in the water. I'm just going to go inside of here in this section. And it's also a wash right now, so it's going to show the color from the bottom really well. So what we just want to do here is we want to make sure that this section appears as though it has a shadow too. Now we're just going a little bit lightly on that section. We're going to do that same thing, that third minaret, or not minaret, this section over here, this third shape. You're going to add a little darkness to it so So it appears as though it's behind that minaret. And it's also just a wash, so the colors from beneath it still show. Now's a good time to start. Go ahead and doing the light colors. So what we want to do is we want to grab that creamy color and some of the brown. So we're going to have a really, really nice light color. Now you can also add in a little bit of orange to make it look like the sunset is really hitting the spots here on the mosque. So we're going to dip a little bit of our brush in the water and wipe it. And then we're going to go here from the top. Then we're going to go in the middle as well. Going to want to add a little bit more color because I'm feeling like it's a little bit dull, so we're going to add a little bit more brown in there and just go a little bit on top of it and voila. Alright, we're going to do the same thing over here at this large section. We're going to go to make a line over here at the bottom as well. And I'm just dipping my brush again. Okay. So we're going to add a little bit more brown in there, a little bit darker. And we're going to go on top of this orange section. So now I just added a little bit of white to my brown, and I'm actually going to want to add a little bit more. And then I'm going to dip my paintbrush in the water again, wipe it on the cup, and then I'm going to make that nice highlight. We're just going to go in like that again, and we're going to go from the top and make a line, and right there, and we're going to make a line at the bottom too. And we're also going to go to the minaret and do that same thing. So the closer you are to the viewer, the more contrast it's going to have. Which is why we're adding really nice contrast to anything that's closer to us. We're going to add another line over here before I forget, because the mosque does have this top part. A line over here too, and adjust the color with our shadow colors. And we also want to have this be light, so we're gonna add a little bit of that color there. So now we also want to add a little bit more of that door. So we're going to get our brown color and we're going to make a door to that entrance. Now we're going to get our shadow color, so that's our blue and red again. And we're going to go into that section over here, in that middle section, and we're just going to move along over here. The reason this is dark is because the mosque itself has this very nice dome shape, and then when you walk inside, you see that door over there. You can go ahead and add a little bit more shadow if you want to those archways. And we're going to do the same thing to these archways over here. Now for the archways on the left side, we're going to want to get a little bit of that shadow color, not too much. So I got the slightest bit of that purple. And then we're going to add just a tad bit of that color. And this is also has a lot of water on it. So it doesn't really have that deep of a purple. Now we're also going to want to get our light color and make a little arrow shape over here at the top because the sun is hitting it over here. And before we forget, we can go ahead and get that shadow color. And go just a little tad bit over here on the side and make a little shadow underneath that line. And the same thing for that second one over here. And we're going to go from the left and start pressing a little lightly, not too much over here, that middle section. Okay. Now you still have your shadow color on your brush. So what you're going to want to do now is dip that paintbrush in the water. And we're going to go a little bit on top of that section. It's going to look a little purple now. We're going to do that on this side. And then we're going to do that on this minaret as well, at the top part. Okay, so now that we have that done, we can... Oh, actually, let's add a little bit more of that shadow color over here. A little too light over here. So we're just going to go in and wash that just a little bit. Our brush, and we're going in circular motion. Just to mute that orange bit. Okay, so now we have the majority of the mosque done. We're going to want to start laying out our pathway. So for the pathway, we're going to get our flat brush. So that's a flat brush again. And you're gonna want to get some brown and some of your purple. So I'm just gonna do my purple again. I'm gonna go over here. I'm gonna add in that brown. And we're gonna want to dip our paintbrush inside of the water. And we're gonna start from the bottom. So go ahead and do some more crisscross patterns like we were doing earlier. And grab some color as you need it. And I'm just going from the bottom and to the corners and then up again. And I'm just doing that crisscross pattern. And I'm leaving that middle section a little light so that it appears that we have some light coming in from there. Now what you want to do though is with that same color is you want to go ahead and make a line from that minaret. And it's gonna make a very slight triangle right over here. And that's our shadow from the minaret. And as you get to the end of that shadow, it's gonna be a little lighter than the beginning. Okay, we can go back in there as well later. We're gonna do that same thing with the color, that dark pathway color over here. On the right side of our mosque, and we're going to do another triangle-like shape. And this isn't too much color, we're just doing a small wash of that color. So now we have like a little shadow coming in from each side. And you can grab as much or as little of that. I'm just adding a little more the sides of that so that it appears from the beginning of the shadow to be darker. We want that. We want that darkness to be at the beginning. So if you really want to get that darkness, make sure to add more purple. Or more black as well. You can add black to this as well. It's just gonna get that nice deep color. I'm just going to add a little more of that dark color. I really like that color. It's such a rich color. Okay, now I'm just dipping my brush in there. And I'm adding some of that washed out color to that right side of my canvas. Okay. Now on the left side of my canvas, I'm not going to want to put too much of this color because we don't want it to look too dark, but we're going to go ahead and do that to that left side. We're going to add a little bit, just a tad bit. Okay. Now for everyone's favorite part, we're going to start working on the dome. So go ahead and wash your brush completely for this. And you can wipe it on something and wipe it on my apron. So you can go ahead and we're going to get some orange. some yellow. So if you don't have, an orange, you can mix in some red and some yellow. Make sure to have more yellow than red. And we're also gonna get a tad bit of brown. We're gonna mix in some white. I'm gonna add a little bit more of that orange. Okay, and then we can go ahead and we're going to start going from that left side. And we're going to just go inside of that dome. We're gonna do the whole thing this color. And then we'll come back in and we'll add some shadows. I mean, it's gonna get less and less color from that bright side. We're not gonna want too much of that yellow. So we're going to add our purple. We just mixed in a little purple and some brown. And we're going to put in some water and wipe our brush on the side of the cup. We don't want too much of this color because it's going to be blending in with that. And we're just going to go so lightly on that right side of our dome. And we're going to I should probably be using my detail brush, so I'll go back in there with my detail brush as well. But we can get this nice little shade over here even with our flat brush. So I'm going to go ahead and get my detail brush. Adding a little bit more of that creamy color. I'm coming back in there. And then I'm just going in circular motions. I'm getting that handwork out today. Just going in circular motions and blending our shadow with our light color. And I'm actually going to get a little bit of orange, a little bit of yellow. And a little bit of white. I'm going to make a circular motion again. And this is on the left side of that dome. And we're just going to go a little bit bigger and bigger every time. And we're just gently doing this. So we should not be pressing too hard on this. And then I'm going to want to get a lot of white because I'm seeing that left side is getting left out and you can't tell it from the sky. So now we're just going to get that white, orangey color and we're going to go in there and just like so, get that dome. And then we're going to do the same thing to our minaret's top. So we're going to go here and make a triangle again and two lines. Go here and make a triangle, two lines. And we're going to get our brown, add in some brown. And we're going to go in there. And just in the center of that minaret top, we're going to make it just a softer shape. So at the top of our, so now we got our minaret and we got our dome, and we're just going to add a little bit of shadow on that top part over here again, because I'm feeling like it's still too bright. So we're going to add a little shadow color. Is that purple? And we're just going to do a wash on top of here. And we can go ahead and do that same wash on that side, the top of that minaret part. Okay, so we're almost there. We're going to want to add a tiny, tiny line over here, and just an ever so slightly small U-shape. Very, very tiny U-shape. And a little line. And that's going to be our top of our dome. And we're going to want to get our cream color. And we're going to go on the left side of this shape, and then we're going to complete our loop. So there should still be a little bit of that dark color so that it shows. But see how it, when you do the dark color on the right and then the light color on the left. So now we have the main mosque complete. We're going to add some color to that water. Now if you look at the sky, it's a little orange, a little blue. We're going to add a little orange because we already added some blue to make some kind of reflection. But we're also going to make sure that we take a bit and we're going to add some water. And it's okay to have this runny, because when you have runny paint, it kind of looks more like water. So I'm just going side to side, and I'm filling in. I'm not completely filling it in, but I have some orange there. So I'm just going and doing like a zigzag. We'll come back in there with some blue. Make sure to wash your brush before you go into the blue, because then it'll make a brown color. So we're going to get some of that blue, and we're going to come from the bottom, and we're going to go up just a little bit and meet the orange halfway. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. We're going to do like a swirly, swirly, swirly pattern. And we're going to meet the orange halfway. Okay, so now we got most of that water complete. And now what I want you guys to do is grab a brush that maybe has been, has a life. It has been through so much. And you want to get that brush, and we want to use our green. Now we're going to use our green, and we're going to add some bushes. So if you don't have a green, you can mix your blue, and you can bring some yellow. You have a green. But make sure not to use this really bright green, because it's very, very bright. You can add some red or some orange or some brown to mute that tone. So we're going to go ahead and add some of that brown, and see how that is just a little bit more of a realistic green. So we can use that. And we can start over here at the side, and we're just gonna tap. We're just gonna tap, 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 tap. It's okay if it gets different places. We like that texture. And you can really, really just be free with this. Okay, we're gonna do the same thing on this side. We're just tapping away. Alright, so now we're going to add a little bit of yellow and a little bit of red to this green. And then we're going to mix in some white so that we have some highlighting colors. So now we have a really nice highlight. We're going to go back in, and on the left side of the trees, we're going to tap a little. And as we get to the ones that are more on the other side, we're going to do less and less. Just adding in a little bit more white. Yeah. Really get it in on this side. So now we kind of have an almost complete painting. We're going to add just some pillars. I'm gonna show you guys real quick how this works. Then we'll be almost done. So you can get some of your black and some of your brown. And we're going to want to add just a little bit of yellow. I'm going to add some more brown to this. Alright. Now I really want like a darker, different color. And I like this kind of dark green color. So we're going to get that color. And we're going to start making... And we're going to put it in the water. I forgot to mention that. Put it in the water and wipe it on the cup. And we're going to make some pillars. And we're just doing that by going up, up, up with our flat brush. And now as you get to the curve, you're going to want to make small, you're going to make them closer together. And then when you get closer to your side, so if you were standing here, if you're standing here next to the mosque, you're going to make them a little taller, and you're going to make them a little more, with more gaps. So, you see how it starts off? You can start off with more pillars, and as you get closer, there's less and less. We're going to do the same thing on this side, just going up and down. And we're making them further apart as they come towards us. Okay. Now you can add a line. And this line is just straight across. And you can make it bigger once it comes closer to you. We're going to do the same thing on this side. Right through, and be as confident as you can when you're making these lines. Okay. I'm just adding a little bit more shadow because I like shadow. Alright, I think we got a painting here. We've got our lights, we've got our darks, we've got our sky, and we've got our passageway and water. I think we are done. Well, it was so nice to have you guys. I'm so happy that we got to paint Mary and Masjid together. I hope you guys enjoyed this and learned something from it. And I'm just happy that you even came on this live with me. So thank you so much. I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your Ramadan and have a great day. Assalamu alaikum. Before I forget, go ahead and send me pictures of your completed painting if you have them. You can share them here on the Friends of Islamic Art Society page, or you can share them to my Instagram on a private message. My Instagram is Hidayat, so that's Hedayaat. Alright, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.